Hey folks, welcome back to Math Teacher Lounge. I'm Dan Meyer.
And I'm Bethany Lockhart Johnson.
Throughout this current segment, we're talking about with people who do math and help people do math outside of traditional school settings. It's a blast, and we're so lucky to have Omo Moses here to chat with us today. Omo, thanks for being here. So MathTalk is that you co-designed a space with people in the community to create these positive interactions in a public space around mathematics, which really got Bethany and I just talking a lot in our prep. And I know we both have lots of questions for you about how that went and what our teaching audience, audience of parents can do that's similar.
Thanks, Dan. And thanks, Bethany. You know, it's great to be here with you on this program talking about mathematics. You know, to be honest with you, math was not my favorite thing to do as a kid. I grew up in a family of mathematicians, and, you know, we talk about math being the family business, but, you know, we had to do math on weekends, we had to do it during summers. You know, coming out of that experience, when I became a dad, like most sons, you want to do things a little bit differently than your dad did them with you. And so I wanted math to be something that my son and I enjoyed doing, and for it to be something that we did playing basketball, or we did at the playground, or we did while we were making breakfast. And so that was really some of the inspiration for all this work, was really as a father thinking about the relationship that I could have with my kid around learning. The other inspiration kind of draws out of the work of the algebra project, and the algebra project really schooled me in thinking about how learning can take place in a community context, how math can arise from kind of common language and common interactions and conversations. That led us to thinking about, well, what if, you know, math was like a visible and vibrant and joyful part of our communities? And so how can we begin to have conversations with people that live in the community about that?
Yeah, I love the words that you use when you talk about math, this joyful, vibrant, playful. And as a teacher, I know that when I would talk with parents about math experiences at home or the work we're doing in class, so often the parents' experiences with math are what would come through loudest, right? The first thing they'd say is, oh, I've never been good at math, or, oh, no, I don't like math. How do we help parents kind of reclaim that math or heal that relation, really heal the relationship that they have with math?
Yeah, there's a lot of math trauma out there, a lot of math anxiety.
Yes.
Math has a bad rap, and people have learned math from the perspective of, you know, you got to get an answer right. You have to memorize or manipulate something. I think there's an opportunity with parents to help them revisit what they recognize as mathematics. And so it's not about, you know, and particularly with young kids, you know, just think about the words that you're helping kids learn, like big, small, kind of farther, nearer, closer, you know, just all the things that you're in conversation with your child around has some kind of mathematical relevance. But then also kind of reorienting themselves to think about math as something that is about a conversation. It's about an exploration. It's not about trying to get to a right answer.
I'm super curious. Like, you know, teachers have the experience of like prepping a lesson. They think it's going to be awesome. And then It just like falls on the floor or whatever. And others go great. You've done created all these installations or experiences, exhibits out in on the world of mathematics. Can you just like really get really concrete for our audience and like, let us know, you know, like what of these have like worked really, a couple that have worked really well, or even surprised you how well they worked? Like, what are people actually doing mathematically out in the world with your exhibits?
Yeah. So we started off, you know, super kind of excited. We're going to create these visionary kind of incredible installations. but then we backed away from that and just thought about, you know, what are simple things that people can recognize that are relevant to what's happening in the classroom that can be extended out of the classroom into the community And like, what are different games that people can play on that? So an example, one of our installations is a giant number line. And so there are different ways in which kids can kind of engage with the patterns and explore it in multiple ways. You know, we have kind of prompts around, you know, playing Simon Says on the number line or hopping on the number line as ways in which kids can physically interact and engage with it. We have an installation that's all circles, and some of them are kind of intersecting in different Venn diagrams. You know, the idea is, well, you know, how can someone use this with their bodies or with what's in their physical environment? The minute you put a mathematical idea in a public space, I think it sends a different message to kids and to folks in the community about mathematics. And so I think it has the potential to facilitate a different relationship by the fact that it's just there. I mean, it's funny with my kids. So their first experience with the number line are these kind of huge lines that are in parks or in public spaces. And so, you know, we created a small number line on paper with my daughter. And then I said, well, all right, now let's take a trip on the number line. And she just started looking at me like I'm crazy. Like, I can't take a trip on this small piece of paper because she's used to that means I'm going to walk on it. I'm going to go here, there, and all that. And then, you know, she said, or my oldest son said, well, why don't you get one of your toys or your dolls? You know what I mean? And then the doll
can
take the trip on the line.
That work of saying the little number line is kind of the same as the big number line and the little doll is the same as the big me is that, I mean, that's like mathematical work of representing and is it like a variable even like the doll is a variable that stands in for your daughter.
I'm just so honored that we to get to speak with you and to hear about these amazing projects. And I think they're really shifting the conversation in homes, in communities about math. And we're really honored to share that with our viewers. And we definitely want folks to keep engaged and learn more about your project, about Math Talk, about the work you're doing across the country.
Where's a great place that where people could tune into your work, support it, access it, learn from you?
Check us out on our website. It's math-talk.com. And feel free to reach out to me directly. So I'm omo@mathtalkpbc.com. And, you know, we love to be in conversation with folks thinking about, you know, how do I do this in my home? How do I do it in my school? How do I do it in my neighborhood? How do I do it in my city? So whatever level of conversation folks want to have around it, we'd be happy to engage them with that.
You can email us, mathteacherlounge@gmail.com, or you can send us a tweet at MTLShow. You can also join us. Our Facebook is Math Teacher Lounge. The Teacher Lounge Facebook is designed for math educators just like you, where you can continue this conversation. Mr. Moses, it has been an honor to speak with you, and we are truly inspired by your work.
Thank you, and keep doing what you're doing. This was great.